Hi guys, it's April 2nd of 2015 and I am in Invercargill. It's south of New Zealand, all the way down, all the way south. Can't go any further unless you go to Antarctica. It's kind of dark because it's 6 o'clock at night. I am in an incredible park that I just discovered. And I'm actually here attending conference. It's my third day of the conference I'm attending. It's Women and Men on the Frontlines. And there is so much to say. I'm absolutely overwhelmed. And I'm not type of person who goes to conferences. It's just not my thing. And I strongly felt that I needed to attend this conference, and I mean fasted, which is huge for me because I love food so much. And some incredible things happened. God actually came and met me where I was. And, you know, I went from weeping and crying to laughing my pants off almost. It was incredible. Some of the people, speakers, were Patricia King, Lynn, and Robert Parker, and another absolutely incredible woman. So Patricia King is from America, Lynn and Robert are from New Zealand, and another amazing woman, Rory, from Australia, and this woman is incredible. I think it's by far one of the best preacher I've ever met, you know, like just so real, down the ears. The sense of humor is absolutely incredible, but just goes deep in your heart and challenges you. It just was amazing. Of course, I mean, they're amazing, amazing speakers and prophets and apostles out there, but sometimes in certain seasons, you know, there are certain people speak right into the areas where we need. It's getting dark and my head doesn't probably help. But I just wanted to say hi, and because I cannot even articulate everything that's been happening. I'm going home tonight. Probably won't get home until 12 o'clock because it's far. It's not far. It's only 1 hour away. But I almost gave up. I almost dropped everything and went back to U.S. And I came here with and hoping that God will give me some clear direction. And He not only answered questions that I have, He actually exceeded my expectations, and He showed me clear where I need to go and the steps that I need to take. So He's so good. Some amazing things happen, and I hope I will just type it up and send it to you. Okay, love you guys. Bye. Here's this thing on perseverance, right? Because I was on the verge of giving up. I had all these emotions piled up and just didn't know where I'm supposed to do, where I need to go. But one thing I really knew, I wanted to stay in the will of God. He's my father. He's my papa. I mean, what else am I going to do with my life but to live for Him? That's what I want. So I went to this conference with intention of getting an answer, and here's the thing about perseverance, right? Don't just persevere. You are perseverant. Don't just be courageous. You are courage. It's within you. It's inside you. That's who you are. That's who I am. I am perseverance. It's my mantle. That's what I'm wearing from the day I was born. Not giving up and just pushing on. And even though sometimes it's felt like I did give up, but not really. So that's one thing that I really wanted to share, is that you are perseverance. It's within you. It's that's who you are. And the courage, it's inside of you. That's who you are. Anyways, how can I articulate everything that I have experienced?
But take these truths and day by day focus on them. Preach them to yourself every morning. Get alone with God and preach His word into your mind until your heart.
Those who fought in the liberation of Europe, in the defense of Britain, in Korea, Borneo, Vietnam, and Afghanistan. In our own land and the unknown resting places in every sea. We remember all who have fallen since in the defense of peace on land, in the air, and on the sea. We remember each man, woman, and child who has died so that light of freedom, justice, and humanity may continue to shine. Today, as we remember, we ask God that we and our successors may prove worthy of their sacrifice. Let us pray. Lord God, as the sun rises this day, as it did on that first Anzac Day 100 years ago today, help us to remember the sacrifice of the first Anzacs and the generations of men, women, and children who have died in the cause of liberty and peace. Help us to remember those who bear the physical and mental scars and disability of their service. Help us to remember the widows and widowers, girlfriends and boyfriends, parents and orphans, sisters and brothers, all who waited in vain for the return of a loved one. Help us to remember the comradeship, agony, courage and compassion of all the servants, but save us from ever glorifying the horror and tragedy of war. As the sun rises on this day, Lord God, help us to remember.
You strive down to bind me up. You say you do it all in love, that I might know you in your suffering. And though you